This is Evan Abrams, and in today's After Effects tutorial, we're going to be taking a look at keyframes that govern position. And we're looking at a special kind of keyframe. It's called a roved keyframe. You know, it's not like the linear or easy-eased keyframes right here, but it's pretty different, and it helps make things smoother. You know, it'll make you into like a smooth guy or a smooth girl, or I guess you could just shave to have that. But, you know, who wants to do that? Let's get into After Effects and smooth it out. So, here in After Effects, I guess I have to answer a couple of questions. First, what are roved keyframes, or roving keyframes, or keyframes which that roam? Well, first, a keyframe is something that holds information, in this case, positional information. And a roving keyframe has no set time. So, this keyframe here at the beginning has a time and a place. Okay, its time is 24:05. At this time, it's saying to this layer, be at this position. Okay, and this one here, similarly, you know, same deal. It's got a time, it's got a place. Okay, these keyframes here in the middle, they have positional data, but they don't have temporal data. Okay, they just kind of hang out, and they go wherever these two keyframes here at the end tell them to go. So we're going to look here at the graph editor real quick, and you can see that here on the graph editor, if I start pulling this handle, these keyframes start moving around, right? And they move around, you know, one way or the other, depending on the influence of these two keyframes at the end. And that changes the way in which this moves over time. Think of it like stretching and skewing, but with time, not space. So everything in between is moving in relation to these other two things, which is pretty cool when you want to create things like, you can see how this would be a spaceship flying in and you're controlling the curve of the speed of the spaceship. So that's pretty great. But roving keyframes don't apply to everything, and they can be a little bit nuanced and tricky, so I'm going to take you through making some and using them for some kind of effect. So I'm just going to go here in the project. I'm going to create a new composition. Call it Comp2, if you like. I already have some solids made, so I'm going to bring one out here to serve as the background. I'm going to create a new shape layer, and within that shape layer, I'm going to make a circle or an ellipse or something. So just a little circle, just like that. What we're going to do with this circle is move around its position. So call up its position by hitting the P, right? So you select a layer, you hit P, then you can deal with its position. And I'm just going to go ahead, a bunch of keyframes here. I'm holding down shift and hitting, you know, page up and down to move ahead 10 keyframes. I'm going to click the stopwatch here to create my first keyframe. And it has created a linear keyframe. Linear keyframes are diamond shape. Okay, I have a tutorial all about keyframes and the different types of keyframes. This roving keyframe was not covered in that. So we've created a linear keyframe. Cool. We're going to go ahead dragging the playhead. And I'm going to put it over here. So I'm just dragging, and that creates a new keyframe. Now I'm going to move ahead a bit again. I'm going to go over here. I'm going to move ahead again. And I'm going to move down here. Cool, and move ahead again, and put it right here. All right, so that seems good. So now we've got, you know, this thing, it's moving along this path in this way. So we've created these keyframes in space. And when you select a keyframe, you can grab these handles around it, and, you know, you can start to move it around, and you can affect this line, this path, that the keyframe is essentially going to have things follow. So that's what we're doing right now. So we're bending this path around, and this is affecting things in space, but not in time. So just the same way we can bend these handles in space, we can grab these keyframes, go into the graph editor, and affect them in time. So when we look at this graph, and we're looking at a speed graph, remember, edit speed graph, not a value graph. This is the value graph. All right, so we look at the speed graph, and we see it is linear. So there is a linear relationship in terms of speed. It's at a constant speed for all of these times. Constant speed on the plateaus. These vertical lines here, I don't think should really be there. I think this should be a filled-in graph, just because there isn't anything happening between this vertical line. You know, it shows you the delta between how fast it was going and how fast it is going, but other than that, not much. So you can see it's at one speed, and then it's going to kick into a new speed and then into another speed. So it's very rigid, it's very linear, definitely not smooth. So when we create smooth motion, usually we would easy ease them. But if we go animation keyframe assistant easy ease, once we ease them, have a look at the graph now. It's going up and then down to zero, and up and then down to zero. So it's going to one point, stopping, and then accelerating to the next point. That's not what we wanted either. We want it to be smooth from the first point to the last point. All right. So to accomplish this, we select these keyframes in the middle, right-click on them, and say Rove Across Time. And now it's changed them into these little dots. All right, let's go back to the graph editor. So these dots here are now positioned on this curve as they're expected to be in accordance with these handles, right? So if I stretch this handle, it starts to push them in this direction. And what does that mean? It means it's going to be a slow start, and then it's going to start to ramp up faster, 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 fastest, and then back down, right? And you can see here these dots along this path have changed to represent that too. Close together dots mean not a lot of movement. Far away dots are more movement. Each dot is where it is on that frame. So dot, 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 and so on. So the dots are helpful to let you know how fast things are going. And looking at this graph, you can also sort of tell. And roving keyframes are primarily used to make position work well, all right? If we wanted to do something else, like let's say we delete these and we want to mess with the scale, right? So I want to set a keyframe here and I want it to be at like zero, and then I move ahead, la 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 la, and I want it to be at, you know, a high number, and then I move over here and want it to be a low number. And I want to rove this keyframe. Well, I right-click on it, but I can't say rove across time. And that's because roving keyframes are really only used for positional problems. That's because it has to take into account things like inertia and speed, and that just doesn't exist on this kind of a thing. Here's a little trick to get around that, though. Remember we had some roved keyframes, right? It was doing stuff. It's going all over the place. All of these values are still captured in here, right? So you can use this positional data, you know, duplicate this layer, which I do by hitting Command-D or Control-D. Let's remove the position keyframes from this. Let's call it its scale and put an expression on here. And let's say we transform the scale to be, one of these things and see how that goes. Well, now it's going to be roved, but, it's just going to be taking in the positional data and then outputting it. So that's one way you can use roved keyframes in things that aren't position, but, you know, usually you just use them in the position because that's kind of what they're for. It's kind of for smoothing out motion in that way. Now you're probably asking yourself, well, what do I do with this information? Great, I have roved keyframes, but other than smoothing out these stupid curly Q things, what is the point? Well, one of the things you can use it for are creating sort of bouncing effects. So let's look at how I started this thing, right? We've got this thing that bounces in, boink, like this, and it's kind of an oscillating, gyrating thing. Now, you could have used an expression. There's a great inertia bounce expression by Gray Machine. I recommend everybody have that on their bookmarks. But what I did on this is just using two roved keyframes in between, and it just bounces like that. It uses way less resources from your computer and is very controlled in terms of creating this bounce. Really, the two keyframes are just a bit higher and just a bit lower than where we want this thing to end. And all in, I think it's a pretty good solution to having this thing bounce in with a little bit more life using roved keyframes. So hopefully this little primer on roved keyframes has taught you a thing or two about a different set of keyframes that probably you haven't used before. And hopefully it helps you smooth out some of your motion out there, because nothing looks hackier than linear, terribly accelerated motion. Anyway, this has been Evan Abrams. Hopefully you've enjoyed this channel. If you like learning about motion graphics and After Effects, then you should definitely subscribe. I try to put out new content every week, but I mean, it's not always possible, but at least I'm trying. If you have questions about this, just leave me questions in the comments section of this video, and I'll try to get back to you. And if you want to talk about After Effects or motion graphics in general, hit me up on the Twitter or on Facebook or on the Google+. You know, links to all that stuff is in the description. And yeah, hopefully you had fun with this. Hopefully this helps you out in your projects. And if you subscribe to the channel, then I'll see you around the internet. Thanks a lot, and have a nice day.